Kern, Dr. Rupesh Maurya, Dr. Arain Gosai to the panel. So we will start this webinar by opening remarks by our Honorable Provost, Professor Dr. J.S. Yadav. Dr. J.S. Yadav is a visionary who led CSIR IICT Hyderabad in the capacity of director and scaled it to new heights under his able academic leadership. Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Laureate Awardee, Professor Yadav is a towering scientist in natural products chemistry who is acclaimed worldwide for his contributions and professional accomplishments. His academic and research zeal can be understood from the fact that he has published over 1,300 publications in high-impact journals with over 27,000 citations and 150 patents registered to his name nationally and internationally. He has guided about 250 PhD students and is still guiding a couple of students in Indrashil University. His illustrious career as an academic leader, scientist, and researcher is an inspiration to many, and we are really very fortunate that all the programs under School of Science are mentored and led by Professor J.S. Yadav sir, and the school is progressing very.
કદી કેમ નહીં એવું મારા બધા સગા વાળા બહેનો
I think there is some
problem.
Yes, I see that.
You know, the Vijay Singh, his classes are also going on parallelly.
Okay.
Sir, you are mute. Vijay sir, please unmute yourself.
Is it classes Rupesh. Are also going parallelly? No.
Rupesh.
No, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
आप सबको बोल दीजिए फैकल्टी को कि स्टूडेंट्स को रिलीव कर दे टू जॉइन दिस वेबिनार
यस यस मैम
अभी बोल दीजिए फैकल्टी को
हेलो सर आर यू एबल टू
यस मैडम वी कैन हियर यू
Yeah, so it was disconnected from where I couldn't follow. Is it, I gave the introduction completely?
Yes.
Yeah. So should I begin from the very first?
No need.
Huh?
No need.
But
all the people know, Ram also knows.
Yes. Sorry, sir. Sorry, this connection problem was there. Yeah.
Right.
I will restart this. Then it will be okay.
Good.
Okay. I will restart my program because I don't see any only voice is coming.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir. Now I see.
It's okay now.
Now we are okay, sir.
Okay, Nidhi, there is no need to introduce. Already introduced enough. But the thing is,
yes, sir.
Where is it? Dr. Bharati? Or Vijay, you have
yes, sir.
To not take the classes now.
Okay, sir.
No, sir, nobody is taking classes.
Nobody, but why participants are so less?
Sir, I'm finding out I'm going.
Okay.
Yeah, main ja rahi hu.
Is all right? You know, Ramraj Sekhar, I know, I think almost going to be more than 15 years now, maybe more than 15 years. And I knew him when he was a director of CMAP. See, many things, anyway, Rupesh Maurya will introduce him, but I will introduce him with something which is not written in his CV and all those things. You know, he's the one who started culture of taking patent in IIC Bangalore. Hardly anybody was taking patent in IIC Bangalore. Actually, they were not considering that patent is so important. Not only he showed the patent, also earned so much money that was an eye-opener for IIC Bangalore, that through patent you can earn money. And he was the only professor who was driving Mercedes Benz in the IIC campus, right? And not only that, see, also he purchased land outside Tamil Nadu and gave to those tribe people for their livelihood. That you will not find in his CV. We made all kind of arrangement, new crop development, so that they can not only livelihood, they can earn a livelihood with honor. Okay? And he created them like an entrepreneurship, which is a great achievement. And when he was CMAC director, he went to some temple, he saw a lot of flowers are being used, a lot of beggars are there. He felt, why not you make use of this flower and make agarbatti out of that. And today, you know, agarbatti is commercialized with his attempt in UP, Kanpur area, because he was in Lucknow, Kanpur, not far away from there, Lucknow. So many people have taken up and now they produce in large scale. A lot of people are employed through this. So he has been always, you know, down to earth people and see how they can get benefit from out of his research. And his research has always found application, okay? That kind of things he has done. So I don't see any scientist in India practical like him, where research direct finds application to the society. That's what he has done. And that's what, so I will not take much of his time because I'm sure a lot of people are eagerly waiting for his lecture. So we can proceed. Only thing I can say, we are lucky that he has accepted our request and today he's giving a webinar for the benefit of our people, okay? I'm sure he has promised, I'll invite him to come and stay for 2-3 days and visit different facility of Cadila, and I'm sure he will oblige. So thank you, Dr. Ram, for
thank you for
accepting our offer. Okay, go ahead with the program, okay? Nidhi.
So thank you so much, Yadav sir, for telling us your personal experience about Professor Ram Raj Sekaran. And now I invite our head of department, Dr. Vijay Singh, to give a formal introduction about Indrashil University. Dr. Vijay Singh?
Yes, Nidhi. Can you see the share slide?
Yes, okay. We can see.
Okay, so on the behalf of Indrashil University, I welcome all of you to see and visit. So Indrashil University is the inspiration from our founding of the Cadila Pharmaceutical Indrapadan Modi ji, and now the founding chairman and chancellor of our Rajiv Modi sir. His parents, loving parents, so the Indrashil was started like Indra from his father name and Sila Ben from his mother name. So Indrashil was made, and the Cadila Foundation Pharmaceutical was started in 1951. This is one of the earliest where the Cadila was started. So the aim of this university is to make the world-class education, world-class research, and the training at the Gujarat. So this is the aim where we want. So the Cadila Pharmaceutical was started in 1951 with some of the product. Then in 2016, we started the education initiative by this Cadila Pharmaceutical. And 2018, the Indrashil was born. This is one of the first life science university in India, which is more dedicated in the life science with all this new technology like the genome editing, system biology, bioinformatics, synthetic biology, metabolic engineering, molecular biology, along with the organic synthesis, nanoparticle, nanoassemblies. So these are the our initiative, and we want to translate really the scientific knowledge into the societal benefit product. And this is supported also the by Atal Incubation Center in 2019. And now we have the Indraseel Innovation Foundation, where the student startup innovation policies is happening. So we are growing exponentially in the Gujarat region, and we are building our new student, and the newcomer will come, and the university is going. So this is the one of the platform where we have very, very bright minded faculties and the leader also. So it's Nidhi already told about Dr. J.S. Yadav. He is the one of the very humble, nice person, and under his leadership, we are growing very, very well. And we are expecting to be more. So as we know, he is the person where 250 human resource was produced. So this is the one of the record in India, and he has more than 1400 publication. This is also one of the record, and he got the 150 plus patent and the more than 27,000 citation. That he is the one of the highly cited researcher in worldwide. So with his natural product, he is well known for the organic synthesis and the natural product synthesis. And now he is our provost, mentor, trustee, and the director of the Indraseel University. So we are growing under his, and he is the recipient of the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar, Jesse Bose, and many of the award. And why do you need to choose the Indraseel University? Because we are doing academic excellence, where students have a lot of freedom to choose the subject, skill, communication, development, club activity. So number of things is coming, and they are going to have. So we are also giving the extra classes for the student, special classes, NET, GATE. So this thing have happened. And our courses is designed as the industrial exposure. We can get the internship from the university. Industries and the different institutes. So we have now the 7 MOU from the abroad university and some of the top level national institute. And the student is going to place for the internship and the placement. So we are helping assisting 100% of the placement and internship program for the student. And we want to do all type of the 360 development of the entire student, and that student can lead the global level education, and they can meet, so they are enough competitive. At the Indraseel University, we offer number of the courses. In the School of Engineering, we offer the BTEC in Computer Science and Engineering, where the machine learning, artificial intelligence, or other new idea and program is going to happen. We have the BTEC in mechanical engineering. We have BTEC in biochemical, where bioprocess, fermentation, new product, energy, fuels, everything is going to cover. And we have PhD in all these three areas. Under the School of Sciences, we have the BSc Honors, 140 credit courses in chemistry, and we have the BSc Honors in Biosciences, that is completely aligned with the UGC curriculum. So we are following the UGC and the CBCS system, where the student have choice and they can move somewhere in and they can study the same subject. We have the MSc in Chemistry, we have MSc in Animal Biology and the Microbiology, and the PhD in the Bioscience as well as the Chemistry. And we have the international collaboration, where the student can do some of the part for their study outside of the country. So we have the MOU between this Sacred Heart University, USA, Tuskegee University, USA, Newcastle University, Australia. So we have the facility of the doing student practical as well as the research. So we have all state-of-art facilities at the Indraseel University for the molecular biology, for the macrobiology, for the organic synthesis. And I'm showing here one of the major equipment, which is called the nuclear magnetic resonance. And this helps to get the determination of the structure of the organic molecule, and it can help to quantify the mixture from the known and unknown. And this is the one of the very expensive equipment, and we have here. So we are fortunate enough to have, and the, we are part of the Cadila. So they are supporting a lot to building and increasing the infrastructure of our university, and a student can get a lot of benefit. Not only that student equipment, we have number of really high in the equipment, and we are going to buy more and more to that can help to increase the knowledge of the student, researcher, faculties, and they can also help to improve the skill. And the skill is going to set for the industrial based application, a job you want to do. And we have the number of MOU from the different industries with the linkage from the Cadila Pharmaceutical, from the DataWise, from the CPL Biologics, GBCL, Apollo Hospital, IRM Energy, Ratnamani. So these are the National Chemical Laboratory, CDRI. So these are the our MOU we have, and the student is going for the internship and also for the job placement. So this is the and this MOU is going to more and more in near future. We have the startup entrepreneurship support, and the, under that we have the Atal Incubation Center and the Indraseel Innovation Foundation. So under the Atal Incubation Center, the any of the idea if you have, then you propose and it will be screened, and we can get the fund from under that, and you can make your own startup. And if any student have the interest and idea, they can come under the student startup and innovation policies, and we are going to fully support his idea. And it can be translated if it's going to the have the very good opportunity and potential for the future market-based product. So at the incubation center at the IU, we access the world-class laboratory, what the facilities we have here, and it can provide the dedicated office and the lab space. There is the provision for the start, like 50 lakh kick grant for the support, and we have 2 crore seed funding for the support of the any innovation and idea, and hand-holding through the renovation of the mentor, industry, government, department, agency, or any public or private. And we will provide the free internet access and the help to the BC Industrial Financial Institute. And we want to the 360 support to the for the startup and innovation for the sustainable business. So this is the, our help. And if you want to know more, you are welcome to here physically, and or you can visit our website, and you can email us, or you can make a phone call. So thank you very much, Nidhi, for providing me the opportunity to talk about the our university. So thank you.
Thank you, sir, for giving such nice introduction about Indraseel University and letting sir know about IU more. And now I invite Dr. Rupesh Maurya to give a formal introduction about Ram Raj Sekaran sir to all the audiences.
So thank you, Nidhi. So I would like to thank Indraseel University for this wonderful opportunity and wonderful expert here. So sir, your CV is so long, like it will take another half an hour to explain, but I will take some of the time in the webinar so to introduce you. So sir is working as a professor and head of department in the microbiology department of microbiology at the Central University of Tamil Nadu, and he has more than 25 years of academic experience in academia. And So he has been serving as a more than 25 years in administration also. So he was director at the CSIR New Delhi Special Project and Initiative, and sir was the director for the Central Food Technological Research Institute at CSIR Mysore, and he was a research director at the Bijam Bioscience Private Limited, and he is chairman as well as member for many committees in India. Okay, so these committees are such as Midday Meal Committee, Academy of Scientific and Innovative Research. So he is acting director also for the Academy of the Scientific and Innovative Research. And so sir has been awarded for many awards, such as J.C. Bose Memorial Award, as well as J.C. Bose National Fellow. And he's awarded by the G.V. Joshi Memorial Award, and the list is so on. So there are lots of awards, sir, and more than 180 publication, and more than 9 to 10 international patents are there. So sir is also fellow of many academies, such as he's fellow of Indian National Academy, fellow of Indian Academy of Sciences, fellow of the National Academy of Sciences, fellow of National Academy of Agricultural Sciences. So thank you so much, Nidhi madam, for this opportunity, and so I was very eager to listen to you, so because I'm also interested in bioactive compounds. So thank you for Indrashil University for organizing such a webinar. Thank you,
madam. Rupesh, I think one you missed. You know, he has received uniquely Industrial Award as well for Scientific Research Award.
Yes, sir. List is so long.
And normally people get only one, either industrial or scientific. But yes, he has both.
Yes, sir.
Top one, not, you know, this.
Sir, there is one page of list of awards only.
I know. So main point to you. Left.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Ram Rajsekhar, it is your floor now.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
I can hear you, right.
Let me first thank you to bring me to this floor to discuss my recent research and the technology which we have developed recently. I truly appreciate all your colleagues and their enthusiasm and your students to have an open discussion of some of the technologies and followed by the commercialization aspect. I'm really touched with the facilities and the people what you have in Indrashil University. I'm delighted to be a part and have a discussion with you. I think before I start, let me tell something about Professor Yadav. I always tell, even though he was one of the very senior director in CSIR, I say I never seen one of the best organic chemists in my life, and he is one of them. Anytime he calls, I can just say, yes, sir. That's all the word respect I have with him. I don't, anytime I go for a help, even I was in Hyderabad for some of our center in CMAP, he is very open in guiding and also giving a right advice and extending his entire facility to really other people to grow. That is the beauty of him. You are all fortunate to be with him because his selfless way of looking at things really brought many people into the national forum. Thank you, sir. I never had an opportunity to thank him personally. I think I take this opportunity to thank him. Now, today I'm going to really discuss some of my, okay, let me share my screen. And currently, I am at Dean School of Life Sciences, Central University of Tamil Nadu. This I have joined because after CSIR retired, there is 2 years I stayed in my hometown. I will tell you what did I do during that time, very briefly. But the main part, at this time, Professor Padmanabhan asked me to go to this university because he was a chancellor for this university, to close it to my hometown, that hence I took up this job. Today, I'm going to discuss with you only two research projects. The in-between, we'll talk about some stories. And it is done by only two PhD students. I'm going to introduce the first one, and he's one of the PhD students from Andhra. He came and spent time in CSIR and did his PhD. The work which I am going to give you, the basic work, otherwise called the technical work, is done by him. And he got his degree. Now he settled in his life. This is his marriage photo. That way he was so happy. And I asked him for a photo. This is the photo he had sent. Now, let us really try to introduce you. What is the mission about this project? What it is all about? When we decided to start this project, I had an interest saying that eat sugar without fear. We are not afraid of eating sugar, but there are people, they are afraid of eating sugar, our diabetic population, and also people, those who are health conscious, that includes weight conscious, I meant. And they are really having fear of eating sugar because it gives you a lot of calories, and that's the reason they wanted to really have a fear. Now, can we really have the label which is put there in the food, which they say is they put a sugar and then they put a slash around it saying that sugar is not there. But here, the project which we are talking about, you can still eat enough sugar and you will not get that much of calorie. That way you can control your diabetes and also you can maintain the calorie intake. Otherwise, you can maintain your weight. To do that, what is the hypothesis which we have put out is first. The sucrose is actually metabolized by an enzyme called sucrase. The enzyme which hydrolyzes sucrose is called sucrase. If the sucrase is in your tummy, which is there in your tummy, and then you put your sucrose and your small intestine hydrolyzes the sucrose into glucose and the fructose. If this glucose and if this enzyme is not very active and functional, what will happen? You can eat a lot of sugar and have a taste in your mouth, but the hydrolysis may not happen fully, and that way that absorption of this hydrolyzed product of sucrose is not going to the system. How do we achieve this? Because basically, I am not an animal personality. Basically, I am a plant guy. I try to work in a reverse direction. I have decided to look at a plant system. Can I bring a sucrose inhibitor from the plant source and put it in your mouth along with the food and ask this inhibitor to bind with your enzyme, otherwise called a human enzyme, and ask the enzyme not to hydrolyze completely all the sucrose, thereby you enjoy the sweet, but you will not get the calorie. That was the hypothesis. Now, how do we achieve this such things is the question what we have. Let us straightly explain to you what is sucrose in plant system. In plants, sucrose is considered as a transport molecule for human or any animals. The transport of carbon and transport of energy is in the form of glucose. Here in plant system, the transport is done by sucrose. Sucrose is the one which goes around the plant system, and the system utilizes the sucrose and converts it into glucose and the fructose, and that's where it derives the energy. Okay, but if you look at the system which is there in sugarcane, it is a very peculiar than many plants, because apart from it is sucrose as a transport molecule, the sugarcane has a capacity to store sucrose in their stem. But it doesn't store very much in leaves or roots, but it stores very well in the stem. And the way it is achieved is very, very simple. When the sucrose comes into the cells, stem cells, and when the plant is mature, it expresses the protein called sucrase inhibitor. People also refer that as an invertase inhibitor. When these invertase inhibitors expressed in large quantity in the vacuole and the sucrose is not metabolized, it is retained. Now, let us, if this is the case, now let us really come to the human sucrase enzyme. Can I take this plant enzyme, otherwise called the sugarcane sucrase inhibitor, and put it to the human system? How does it really react and what does it do? Which nobody has studied. Then we need to decide to do this part. And nobody has isolated the inhibitor from sugarcane as well. Because in India, sugarcane is the only source. The sugarcane inhibitor is isolated from maize and other sources, but it is not done in this. Then we decided to isolate. Now we have to understand, there are two things which are, we have a human sucrase as the target. Who is going to affect the target is from the plant, that is the sugarcane sucrase inhibitor. These two are the one going to bind and interact with each other. And finally, there is no hydrolysis of sucrose happens. Okay. Now, to do this, what are the things we take? We took the sugarcane, as you see it here, and then we made a juice out of this. We don't drink it. Okay, then we isolated the protein using various columns, and finally we purified the protein and sequenced the protein by mass, and finally raised antibody to this protein. All these are kept in this slide. Then we asked a question. Okay, now we know two things. We have isolated a protein. We are good in isolating these sucrase inhibitor from this sugarcane juice, and all these biochemistry and chemistry is kept there in this slide. The next, what we wanted to do was, apart from this, as a molecular biologist, we decided to clone. We cloned it in the BRCA, again, bacterial size vector, and expressed it and studied both the recombinant protein and the native protein, and tried to do what is the binding affinity between the enzyme, which is sucrase, and the inhibitor. And from these data, we have learned, apart from we cloned and expressed, the purified protein has a good affinity with the enzyme sucrase, and the binding constant, the binding affinity is given there. And these estimations are done by microscale thermophoresis. Now, apart from a classical kinetics, which is done there, this is also performed. Okay. Now we have two things in our hand, a recombinant sucrase inhibitor in our hand. We have a native sucrase inhibitor from sugarcane is also there with us. Now we try to understand this protein with respect to the other one. Then we put this, we modeled the structure. And why did we model the structure? Just we get some clue out of certain things, and we modeled these. And finally, we have to have a target enzyme, that is human sucrase. Best we have to first get it in order to complete the study. Then we decide, if you look at the human sucrase, now I am shifting to human sucrase, that is a target enzyme. These human sucrase is an intestinal alpha glucosidase enzyme. And if you look at it, it is not a very simple enzyme. It is actually a multifunctional enzyme. If you look at it, there are two units which is there. The one unit which you can hydrolyze sucrose, and another unit of the same protein, another part of the unit which actually hydrolyzes isomaltase. Okay. These proteins are as a multifunctional enzyme. What did we do? We took only the top portion, otherwise called the carboxyl portion of these sucrase enzyme, and cloned, overexpressed, and kept these enzymes as our target to study. Okay. Now we have the target enzyme, that is the human sucrase. Then we have a native enzyme and also a recombinant protein and the sucrase inhibitor native protein from us. Then we decided to connect these two and see, do they really interact with each other, is the question which we asked. To ask this question, what are all the things which we have studied? We have done a pull down assay using the antibody which is raised against the native sucrase inhibitor, and we have also done a co-immunoprecipitation to prove yes, it indeed interacting. Then we wanted an in vivo experiment to show yes, these two proteins, especially that sucrase inhibitor and the sucrase enzyme, both are interacting. We have also used biomolecular fluorescence complementation assay to prove one simple point. Yes, the enzyme sucrase, the human enzyme sucrase, indeed interacts with recombinant sucrase inhibitor and also native sucrase inhibitor. And this is what we have found so far technically. Now, let us really look at it. Then we need to really show the binding. Why do we need this? This is the simple experiment. Just the movie is given just to change the way we are. We keep looking at the slide. We wanted to make a little bit of change. And what did we do? We just proposed we know we have illustrated the proposed structure of these inhibitor and put it to the sucrase enzyme and trying to see what are the residues which are involved in interacting with these two is the question number one. The question number two, can I take the minimum the interacting residue and prove this entire point of these interaction? Thereby, I no need to work with the long protein of 22 kilodalton size. Can I work with the small peptide? Is the question which we have asked. And if you look at it, these two are interacting. And if you look at from this video, what you see, there is some part of the protein. Now, if you look at these 22 kilodalton size protein, and you have three regions we divided, N-term and middle region and the C-terminal region, cloned and expressed, and asked a question, which part of the protein is very effective in doing this part? Then when we looked at this, then you can see the middle portion is interacting very effectively and inhibits these sucrase. Then we asked a question, can I really make a small peptide? Now I asked a question, the middle protein is one, this is the size of the protein, it's 191 amino acid polypeptide, and we decided to really create these close to 26 regions of the peptide. The sequence of this peptide is given here. Now we synthesize this peptide chemically and asked a question, can this synthetic peptide can do the job, whatever we are trying to do? And this time, this synthetic peptide, we have collected large quantity and also done some small amount of animal studies to show, yes, does it do this job? And when we did these, when we feed large amount of sucrose as a part of their, and when we did the oral sucrase tolerance test, yes, this inhibitor, the peptide, has a property to do small amount of it, the reasonable amount of inhibition, and thereby the blood glucose level is relatively low, that you can see from these graphs. Then we also really looked at it, the sucrase inhibition, the concentration required for this peptide is very high, which if you look at it, it's close to 23 millimolar concentration is required. And it's very strange. The alpha amylase inhibition is, it requires only 1 millimolar. If you look at it, 23 times lower concentration is required to bring IC50 value. That was very surprising for us. Now we have asked this question. Now we have two things. Now I will come to the business part of this scientific study. What is the value of this study? Then we decided the entire funding for the earlier part of the entire technical part was done by SERB. Then I decided to ask for a BIRAC grant to really take this project to the next stage. The next stage is, can I really make this and prove this in an animal model? Also isolate in large quantity, can I have a process for recovering or isolating the sucrose inhibitor? Is the proposal for that. Then I received the grant, and now we look at the proposal. What is the use of this project? Is this project is really needed? Yes. The reason is, we have globally 500 million people are diabetic. Among these, 75 million from India, they are diseased. And they still managing their diabetic conditions by taking drugs. The drugs are very effective, there is no doubt. But the long-term usage of this drug has not only gives a side effect, you know, we are not worried about the side effect, but it's slow, the potency has come down, and that is the concern for this. What this project actually tried to tell you is, can I use the sucrose inhibitor, whether it's a native enzyme, or the recombinant enzyme, or the peptide, and use it as a nutraceutical agent, can it really control the calorie intake for the people, those who are concerned about their weight? And we can also really use this for a diabetic population, not replacing the drug. No, we are trying to see, can we lower the concentration of the drug and increase the small quantity of nutraceutical to have an effective control of blood glucose. That's what we are trying to project. We are not projecting bringing as a drug. No, we are talking about a complementary therapy, not as a drug therapy. From this project, what did we learn so far? Earlier I have discussed with you, we have characterized these sucrase inhibitor from sugarcane and also characterized the human sucrase enzyme. We have the proof of concept with us. And this project is going on very well, in fact. The project is going to end in another 3 months' time, and we made a reasonable amount of progress. Now, when we look at this part, the solution what we are proposing from this project is a nutraceutical project. It is a nutraceutical product. Why do we need these nutraceutical products? The amount of they going through the process of going through entire trials and clinical trials are too much and too expensive. If you decided to go through a native protein, it is naturally isolated from sugarcane. We all eat sugarcane per se. We also drink, for generations we have been drinking, one of the nice enjoying drink is the sugarcane juice. It means you are indirectly consuming the product which is actually there. It has no side effects so far, it has been observed. And why this project is so important with respect to an Indian context? Because India is the major producer of sugarcane and we have a lot of material available. The interesting thing about this product, the nutraceutical which we are talking about, which is the sucrase inhibitor, it is heat stable and acid stable. That makes it easy for us to extract the juice. And you can really precipitate this protein and it becomes easier for us to do. This process actually generates money for the even sugarcane processor and the farmer. In this entire solution what we have, we are trying to isolate from the sugarcane juice before it is being boiled, put into a big tank and boil and then refine the sugar. We are not asking the people to change the way they are doing sugar processing. No, we are not asking the farmers to change where they are, the way in which they are their mode. Here we are just intervening in between and collecting these proteins from the juice. That is the project, and it is going well. Why do we think this project is going to be reasonably successful with respect to a market? Market, you know, we have many different kind of wonderful drugs which are there with us, but nobody has a nutraceutical which specifically targets the enzyme which is sucrase, which is not there, not important. The diabetic population is not going down, it's keep increasing. Now the question comes, can they really make their demands? And maybe these products of some nature will help them to really launch in a market in an effective way. We will not call this as a drug. If you look at the product, the proposal, what we are trying to do as a product is a nutraceutical product. It's a non-pharma treatment. The non-pharma treatment, if you are looking at it, it has been progressively increasing so high and nobody could manage to meet these non-pharma treatment. We want to get into the space of non-pharma treatment for diabetic population. We want to get into the people, those who want to eat more sugar and worried about their calories. And this is the main projection of our entire project. What is this challenge? The simple research projects. Now we have taken to the stage two. And if you look at it, the bottom of your right hand, no, the left hand bottom, you see a small name which is there, a company called Nutriome. Nutriome means nutrition, a complete. Like proteome, genome, then we have kind of word called Nutriome. It is the trademark word for my startup company, which is going on at this time. Now, what I will do at this time, if somebody has any doubts or questions, we can ask before I shift it to another project, which are a little different than this, but I will finish it on time, don't worry. Sir, do you want to, shall I conclude this and then come back, or you want me to stop and complete that project and move on to the next.
Complete will come at the end.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, excuse me, I'll just pour some water. The next project is also related to, you know, because I am passionate about my research, if you look at it.
Yes.
I'm working with palms. I love working with a molecule called lipids. But I love eating them, but I hate they accumulate them in my body and change my phenotype from lean palm to a fat palm. That's the concern which we have. This project actually talks about, can I have a kind of a food or a nutraceutical or a molecule which can be a supplement which actually converts from your visceral fat, like called the Ganesha in front of you, can it convert some part into a brown adipose tissue? And those brown adipose tissue is the hallmark of really burning your energy and creating thermogenic process. It means if you have more brown adipose tissue, you will have more thermogenesis. If you have more thermogenesis, more energy is spent as a form of heat and nothing is stored and then you stay slow. This is the mission of this project. And this project is done by one of the PhD students, Danisha, and that is the project which we are going to discuss a little bit about this. It's a very different project. This project originally started in Lucknow. And that I wanted to tell you, but when I was in CMAP as a director, I started thinking about this project, not did very much, but I can also share some of those data with you. If you just to give you a visual, because we know, because we have been evolving and evolving, eating food, more of a vegetables and others in a recent civilization, and we have been eating food as the medicine, which we talked about it. When our food have been changed, and then you have also changed your phenotype. And if you look at the food which is there, it's a highly high calorie food and no freshness, everything is fried and given to you. This is what which we commonly eat and we enjoy eating. That's the reason we deposit a lot of fat right in front of us. Now, what is that got to do with this picture? Yes, my dream is, can I have your food, eat and sleep and lose weight is the concept. The earlier one which we have, eat sugar without fear. Here we are talking about eat more food and sleep and lose weight. It's a dreamy project which we tried. Let me try to explain how far we are on this project. Let us really try to understand this entire part of the obesity. Because when your intake is more, you take more calories in the form of food and the excess energy is stored in a form of white adipose tissue. It stays right around your belly and that is what white adipose. It's a storage system. If you are balancing these energy intake and energy expenditure, you stay okay, your weight is managed. And if you want to be really slim, what you do, you need to really put lot of exercise, make sure your energy is spent. That is the one way. The another way is you can also think about converting your white adipose tissue to brown adipose tissue. The brown adipose tissue burns all these calories and dissipate as a heat, not as an energy. That's the reason when you have a molecule and then you sleep, your body temperature goes high because of thermogenic process. Thereby, the stored food is spent. Okay. Let us try to understand what are the system in human body which is there. If you look at this white adipose tissue, what you see it on your left hand side is a huge LD that is called lipid droplets. There's a huge lipid droplets which is there as a single unit and that occupies most of the space in the white adipose. The white adipocytes is more than 50% is filled with fat. And contrary to this, and that is white adipocytes are called a storage system. If you come to the other side, the right hand side, you have a brown adipocytes where you have very, very small droplets of lipid droplets and also a large number of mitochondria. Because the number of mitochondria is more, that's the reason the tissue is brown in color. Now, these are all the two systems that exist. Now, you may ask, you know, white adipose tissue is right in front of you, around you, it is there. But on contrary, the brown adipose tissues are there where you see on the baby, where you have your backside and also some part right above the kidney. The interesting part about what we do is you always put some muffler on your head to keep that part clear. That's the reason it is not practiced for fun. It is practiced for a reason. Keep that area warm during the cold time. Okay. These are all the two systems which I have introduced. Our main mission of the project, is it possible to convert to white to brown adipose tissue? And what is the mechanism which is involved? And who is going to do this job? And now we need to bring who is going to do this job? Can I find and look for molecules which are there in food and that can help me? Okay. How do we really look for it? Take any food, every food, and that's one way to look at it. The easiest way to screen them is to isolate mitochondria from rat. And then you ask the question, if your system is uncoupling, it means the oxygen consumption is much higher. That's the reason we use oxygen electrode to monitor whether these mitochondria is coupled or uncoupled. I'm introducing a term called coupling and uncoupling. Coupling here means oxidation and phosphorylation, both are coupled in the electron transport chain. Thereby, you use the electron motive force to synthesize ATP. If this electron motive force is not coupled with the ATP synthesis, it is dissipated as a form of heat that is called thermogenesis. It is at the molecular level. It is not done by ATP synthase. Instead, it is done by a protein called uncoupler protein 1. This can be easily monitored just by isolating mitochondria and then put any of the things which you want to see. Does it do uncoupling or not? Okay, this experiment which we did. And actually, we were looking out for an uncoupler. Where we are looking out for these? This is where my Lucknow experience comes in. In India, I never experienced cold because I stayed only in down south where we have cold. We never have a temperature below 15 degrees. And that way, we never need to worry about winter. Winter means for a fancy jacket that we'll put just for fun. It's not a serious winter. When I first went to Lucknow, I have seen a serious winter. And the people in Lucknow, they are managing this winter with a reasonable minimum amount of clothes and no heating in their home. Still, they manage to keep their body temperature alive, very active. That really surprises me. Then I asked a question. What kind of food the people in Lucknow area eat during winter time? Now we wanted to see which is the food commonly used in winter time. Then we collected the list of foods and did the water soluble extract of all this food and did simple coupling and uncoupling of electron transport chain. And this is what we have done. And we have really done some of these. These uncoupling is done by few, which is given there with the pictures. The first is done by sesame. It is otherwise called dill. And mustard also does. Horse gram and papaya. These four has a reasonable amount of uncoupling, but it is high. Then we decided to ask this question. Can we really take these four food and feed it to an animal and ask a question? Before we feed it to an animal, we decided to see, can we really have a different set of experimentation to demonstrate this extract? Here it is called a water-soluble extract. Can it really increase thermogenic process? The hallmark of thermogenic process is the expression of uncoupler protein. What did we do? We took the adipose tissue. We taken the adipose tissue, incubated with these water-soluble extract for a few hours, and then we did mRNA expression profiling of many genes. Here I am just showing you only uncoupler protein 1. both mRNA expression and also the protein expression by immunoblot is also shown. From this, we have shown among these four, what we have studied, sesame showed a very good induction of UCP1 protein. And we dropped the other one, and then we went back and asking a question, the expression of UCP1 is high, but that this molecule, is it actually doing only uncoupling, not really inducing these UCP1? Because this is the question which we have, we will try to answer that one. It is done in the ex vivo experiment, then we decided to do an in vivo experiment where we have taken the sesame seed and taken the fat, that means the oil out, and we took the entire water soluble part, the otherwise called defatted sesame meal. We extracted all the water soluble molecule and fed it to an animal for 2 weeks and trying to monitor the food intake and also trying to look at serum lipid temperature and glucose level. Everything was done and trying to see this molecule from the sesame seed is capable of doing increasing the UCP, and also there is a slight increase in the elevated temperature, also it is increases, but it is maintaining the blood glucose level when you feed large quantity of sucrose as well. Now we ask this another question. What is the nature of this molecule? That's what we wanted to do. And it is a sesame aqueous extract. Then we did, we took the seed and the crude one, put it into HPLC and then put it into a biogel column. It is the size exclusion chromatography, and then we got some reasonably pure compound, and trying to ask a question, can this compound, which we are trying to isolate, and the purification of this entire process is monitored by just by UCP1 expression. No other animal studies are done, just an UCP1 expression was done to really see whether it is happening or not. It means now we know we have isolated a compound, we put a structure, and finally we realized by using mass and mass, and finally we came out with a structure which is sesaminol diglucoside is the molecule. Then we put it to NMR to show it is the same. And we also wanted to, we monitor this entire part by isolating enough quantity of sesaminol diglucoside and the concentration of sesaminol diglucoside in the sesame seed is too low. If you decided to buy the sesaminol diglucoside, it is 10 milligram, cost approximately 1.8 lakhs from a Japanese company. Then I cannot afford to really do this experiment because of too expense. Then I asked a question, yes, sesaminol diglucoside is the one, it is the water soluble, and the sesaminol diglucoside is doing. We are the first one to demonstrate this sesaminol diglucoside is actually induced UCP, and it's all been published. You can just look at the PubMed to get the information. Because of these, they are so expensive in buying these sesaminol diglucoside. And it is also the concentration of sesaminol diglucoside is too less from the starting material called sesame seed. Then we decided to ask, can I remove these diglucoside? Can I take only sesaminol, which is the concentration of sesaminol in a sesame seed is very high. Then we will be better off just going after not the diglucoside part. Can I take the sesaminol and try to do this entire experiment? And sesaminol is very 10 times cheaper than the diglucoside, and did exactly the same studies what we have done for the sesaminol diglucosides, trying to demonstrate and sesaminol diglucoside and the sesaminol are both behaves reasonably well. The parent compound also behaves very well with the sesaminol diglucoside. That way, he decided to concentrate more on sesaminol, not on sesaminol diglucoside, because of the expensive part of the nature of the molecule. And we did exactly the same experiment and trying to show that is the white adipose tissue conversion into a page. Page means it is in between red and white. Okay, that color is called page. And we have, that is one of the hallmark of looking at, if you keep feeding these animals orally, and then you can take out these brown adipose tissue, and you can also see some amount of white adipose tissue in the calories being touched. Okay. These are all the animal studies which is done. I am not a good animal experimenter to do any one of these. It is done entirely in Indian Institute of Science, and we have done the entire molecular biology and all these work was carried out at the Indian Institute of Science by a person who is there, and her name is Dr. Sona. She is from Molecular Reproduction and Human Genetics Department. She helped us to do entire animal studies, and she is still continuing our animal studies for this. Okay, now we'll go back to the earlier part. And we have done all these systematic studies as a collaborator to see, can it be converted to white to brown adipose tissue? You may ask, is my collaborator is competitive enough to do? She is the first one to demonstrate, and there is a transcription factor called EBF2. She was the first discoverer of a transcription factor which controls the conversion of white to brown adipose tissue. That's the reason we decided to really force her to collaborate with us because of this, and she's excited now because this molecule is doing some job. And they do quite a lot of all the molecular studies. Here what we have done, the earlier experiment, don't confuse. Here what we have done is we always feed the animal with a high fat diet, not fat diet, not the normal diet. Even when you feed a high fat diet, and then give your molecule like sesaminol, alsesaminol, diglucoside, can it control the diet-induced obesity is the question which we asked. And the, what you see, there are genes, expression profile of thermogenic genes, and the nature of mitochondria, and the intactness of mitochondria, and functionality of mitochondria, all the gene expression profile is done. We also done with the uncoupler protein expression profile. All these studies clearly demonstrate if you are feeding sesaminol and sesaminol diglucoside as a part of high fat diet, and the body mass is not increasing that high. I am not saying it is staying slim. The weight gain is 15% lower, only 15%, not high. But that number is very significant. Okay. And then as usual, then we have put all the molecules which are parent molecule, whatever, this, the lignan, which is there in the sesaminol. The chemists have, natural product chemists have wonderfully done all this. Then we took entire, the physiological substrates also, like epinephrine, norepinephrine, and so on, and did entire docking study to see, is this sesaminol and the sesaminol diglucoside, does it do a great job of managing? Yes, it does. And even sesaminol and sesaminol diglucoside is reasonably effective. And the binding which is happening there, what you are actually seeing, where it is this binding place is there, is what you see is a receptor. It is the beta-3 adrenergic receptor. That's where we are talking about binding, because the question what we have asked, if you are giving that sesaminol and sesaminol diglucoside, how does it bring these entire response with respect to elucidating, increasing the body temperature, reducing the mass, all these physiological response, how do we really look at it? For this, we have kept one of these known compound called CL316243 is one of the known beta-3 adrenergic agonist, and we use that in parallel to really try to understand this part. From my collaborator's data, it was very clear both sesaminol diglucoside and sesaminol promote thermogenesis through beta-3 adrenergic receptors. The data, they don't share some of those data where they have beta-3 adrenergic receptor defective cell lines, and that's where they're trying to do all these demonstration, and they are holding those data for their own publication. Okay. From this, what is that simplest way of putting it? Then you have beta-3 adrenergic receptor. There is a molecule, the sesaminol, we call it as LP-60, that binds, and there will actually triggers a protein called protein kinase A, and that protein kinase A triggers the hormone-sensitive lipase, and the hormone-sensitive lipase hydrolyzes the triacylglycerol, the fatty acid goes into mitochondria, and all the uncoupler protein expressed large quantity and increases the heat. And what we are saying, you can increase your thermogenic process, thereby you will reduce your fat content. Okay, thank you. I'm done with my presentation and I'm waiting for you to ask me any questions which you have.
Thank you so much, sir. It was really very informative talk. And actually for me, it was very useful because I want to lose some weight. And it is very informative from a scientific point of view, like what food we should eat to reduce some lipids. And sir, I will also invite Haren, my colleague, biologist. Before that, sir, I also want to introduce two important person. Mr. Abhinand Pandya, sir, if he is connected, he is the strategic manager who connects us with Indrashil, Indrashil University with Cadila Pharmaceutical Limited. And because our university is also industry driven, it is an education initiative of Cadila. And Professor Bharti Dave, ma'am, she is the dean of School of Science.
Okay.
If they are connected, they can talk. Hello. Yeah.
No, ma'am, I have been traveling back to Kadi, so, you know, very poor connectivity. But thank you, sir, for giving such a special talk. And this topic of nutraceutical has always been close to me throughout. The first thing, why nutraceuticals? Because it bypasses the critical channel of doctors. And the patient is directly reaching with the end users. So if you look at it, the overall OTC market, any molecule is much bigger than that. So if you look at the total addressable market of any OTC molecule is much bigger than any of the prescribed drugs. And it is quite easier for patients to do it. And that's why I like these ideas about nutraceuticals, and we should promote that in a big way. Specifically, the first idea which sir described about sucrose of managing diabetes, it's a big market, huge market, and it can change the scope of diabetes management. And I wish very good luck to sir. Hope this outcome has been somewhere published in New Journal of England Medicine, and it can take India to the next level. The second idea of also thermogenesis is also a great idea. In fact, a few of the Atal incubies which has been coming to us have been, last 6 months I have been promoting them, how vitamin C from kiwi or other molecules can be taken rather than going through the other routes which pharmaceutical is describing. So there are a lot of scope for nutraceuticals. Thank you, sir. And thank you for your valuable talk.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And Bharti, ma'am, if you are there.
Yeah. Good afternoon, sir. So besides the content, what I liked the most about your talk was regarding your CV, sir. It is an exceptional CV, and I chose the height that you have reached in science. The second thing which I liked the most was you took your project to the second and the third stage. So this, you can really be a role model for all the young researchers that are working on various projects, cannot to stop from the very first step. You got the second grant from BIREC also. You approached DBT for the further work. And you had questions and at each and every step of your research, sir. And you had answers for this. So as Yadav sir always tells us, okay, you ask questions, if you do not have answers for your each and every step, nobody can fund your project. You ask yourself whether you are able to fund your project or not. So you had answers at each and every step. You did your this thing work with a logic at each and every step. And this young researchers should really follow this. There is no limit to the grants. If you have answers for all this, there is no limit to grants which the funding agency can give you. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for a very wonderful lecture.
Thank you.
And so I invite Haren to pose questions on behalf of students and audiences. Haren.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Very good afternoon to you all. And very good afternoon to sir. Sir, your lecture was very knowledgeable and with full of all the interesting things. And you have give a deep insight into the topics and also revealed many interesting facts. So there is one question from the MSc semester 2 student, Shipra Pandey. she want to know is these sucrose inhibitor enzymes, means sucrase are been the key part. So do these enzymes have any kind of enzyme imbalance in the body if we intake these enzymes?
No, it is, we are giving only oral route where it is you are eating all the protein. No, if you are in the juice, what are you drinking? You, apart from sucrose, you are also drinking these, the sucrase inhibitor also as a part of it. Okay. What we are saying, there is no side effect which we are saying. The only possibility, the protein which is going in, it really show the response because it has to pass through the acid, it has to pass through these intestinal enzyme, hydrolytic enzyme. Will these be stable is the question which we, that would be the valid question. But this is the food material which we are taking, and that should not have any effect on any time because with civilization we have been consuming this food.
Okay. So, Shipra must be answered. And then the second question is, in water-limited lands and high-temperature areas, metabolic control of sugar into calories conversion using sweet sorghum and sugar beet would be an alternative crops to sugarcane, as sugarcane cultivation is a bit challenging from economically point of view in high-temperature areas.
Yeah, high-temperature areas, yes. What we are saying, sugarcane survives because of these high temperature. It requires the beetroot. Actually, we call it sugar beets. Are very, it grows more into the northern part of our India, and it is not grown all three seasons. This crop actually stays for 10 months minimum before you harvest. Actually, to tell you, when it goes through 10 months, it goes through all process. It includes all four seasons it has to go through. Harvesting is effectively done on 12th and 13th month in the sugarcane. Now, if you are thinking about putting it on northern part, then we have, it has to see the winter, and the winter may kill the pot. That is the, and sugarcane is reasonably stable in all season, and that is okay. That's the reason Sugarcane Institute is kept in Lucknow for this reason. They can really start right after winter, and then right before they can start the harvesting, that's the best way to go. That's been going on. But if you think about the alternative to sugarcane, is not possible in India, especially in Asia. No one in Asia is cultivating large quantity of sugar beet as an alternative to sugarcane, because sugarcane gives the highest yield and their sugar beet doesn't give that. And this crop is very sturdy. The farmer, the loss is very less. They may not get the price for it, but the loss is not there in this crop. That way it is difficult for them to move away from
it. Okay, sir. So one question is like that, food print technology is an upcoming area for making targeted specific healthy food, 3D food print technology, is it an upcoming area for making targeted specific healthy food?
Yes. Now he is going to be talking about more about a healthy food, because apart from COVID-19 came in and threatened us, we need to be healthy, and it is now, there is a tremendous shift towards looking at a healthy food. And in this healthy food segment, people are also looking at, can I have personalized food, in the sense where we can have, because I have these conditions, under these conditions, I can have only these food comfortably well. These food is also getting popularity on this. And the future is going to be more towards the sector of population, because those who are the sports people, they want to be very active, they don't want to put on weight, and they have specialized food for this. We call it as individual food, instead of calling it individual, we can call it a specific type of food for their need. That can be really, that is the one it is coming up now. For example, the biggest industry at this time booming very aggressively is sports food. They call it as a sports medicine also, but it is not medicine, it is the sports food is picking up very effectively. That's one of the examples which I am telling you. Maybe the people eat very slim, then they need to move to a different type of food. That personalized food is going to be the future for anyone, not only for India, for everyone.
Very true, sir. So all the questions answered very carefully, and over to you, Nidhi ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Ram.
Yes, sir.
You know what you said is a very nice way. That first you define the problem, then find the answer. That's what I keep telling my colleague.
Okay, sir.
One thing I like to do observation. We know that Lucknow Revadi is very famous, you know. They make, covered with sweet, covered with the sesame seed.
Yes.
Very popular. Then also they have very popular sesame seed during winter. Chikki and all kind of laddu they make and eat.
Yes, sir.
That's what they were eating. Probably they may not be knowing the region, but it's a very common, Lucknow is famous for this.
That's where I collected the information from them only. It is data.
Right. And also mustard things they will be using. Either oil or mustard seed, some form or other, they will be using there. That also, that observation of yours was very, very correct. In the south, this is not used that much.
Yes, sir, that's true.
Anybody's house, after dinner, they will give you sesame seed, black seed, like linseed, and also mustard they don't give, but these two seeds definitely they offer you after the food. We have noticed. So that is so what it shows, my colleague, that if observe in your locality, there are in Gujarat, why the food habit is like this, why the people take food this, probably that may find one a good research problem for you people. That's what you have demonstrated, right? So Ramza, I like sugarcane juice, so I have little diabetes. So there's no fear, I can go on taking sugar juice.
Actually, the very interesting sugar companies, that is actually sugar processing company, they wanted to introduce with the sugarcane, that sucrose inhibitor as a part of their sucrose, as called as a diet sugar, real sugar.
Okay.
And that is the one thinking about.
So that's a very good. Just for your information, our Ferrum Technology Rajasri Sugar, in your area, near Kattur. Okay. So they are using our pheromone and they give free Rajasri sugar. You know why? I asked them why they give free to farmers. So they said they don't know. Sugar content is increased when they use pheromone as a control. So they get profit through that one. So we don't mind giving them free. So that's how it is happening. So they're producing sugarcane in Coimbatore area, and they are all using our pheromone technology there. We actually gave them credit. So, okay, thank you for, giving very nice lecture. You go to your program with Helen.
Yes. Thank you, sir. It was really nice lecture. Sir, which plant bioactive will be very good for immune system? According to your experience,
don't know the word. Is there anybody knows the Tamil there? Then if I tell the name, they can understand.
Tamil, yeah. Sir, we have a SIRS student, but I think they are not in this panel.
See, okay, let me give you a simplest version of God's wisdom of nutrition. The word nutrition actually starts from a word, nut. It is called nutrition. Huh? That's the way we should pronounce. What did the God has kept? You have to break something to get good things out of life. If you have a nut which is really harder to break, that has much more nutritious than the one which is broken easily. This is the wisdom. I hope you understand it. Now you go back and look at it. The hardest nut which we have, which is difficult to break, is called something called a stone nut type, that has the highest amount of antioxidants in it.
Okay.
I don't know that the English word for this. Sorry, I've been in Tamil Nadu for too long. that English word is erased from my head. The only the Tamil word stayed in my mind.
Yes, sir.
I just send you a mail. Don't worry. The name of this is called Kadukai. They say Kai means this. It's a nut, basically, and it is really a hard nut to crack. And then I get you the Hindi word name for this. That has the highest amount of called antioxidant, which is known to us. Nobody next to it.
So means if a plant bioactive is having like maximum antioxidants, like you can be free of any of the diseases in the world.
You are defining
because most of the diseases are caused by oxidative stress and all these COX enzymes and all these things.
I think the chemical sites bioactive, which includes Professor Yadav, what they talk about is the actor is a small molecule. They never went back to the bigger size molecule because it is too much to decode what part of the molecule is really doing a job.
Yes.
And still today, when we say bioactive, people are very familiar with the small molecules. Now, I have given you two examples. One, bioactive is a small molecule, right? The molecular weight is not more than 400 to 500. Then another one is a bioactive, which is actually a protein. These people don't talk about protein as bioactives because it is not being implicated in any of these diabetic populations. So never protein or a peptide is available. Now, when you try, I am trying to define to you the bioactive. When you asked which one has the highest, I have taken a simplest example of small molecule which has the highest antioxidant activity, and that is the reason I proposed one name, and it is known.
Okay, sir.
The name of that plant called Kadukai. It's the one which is there. I will send you the Hindi version.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Okay, sir. So, sir, it was really very exciting and interesting webinar and also useful. It is of great practical application. Sir, now I invite our young faculty, Dr. Sanjay Kar, who is also like animal biologist, and to give a formal vote of thanks.
Oh, sure.
Dr. Sanjay?
Yes, madam.
From IU, yeah.
First of all, good afternoon, sir. It was a very nice lecture. We have learned more things from regarding sucrase as well as how to reduce our fat, basically from white fat to brown fat. Before giving vote of thanks, sir, I would like to ask you one question. Sir, what happens if a lean person keep on eating more and more sesame diet? Does it going to affect his metabolism adversely?
No, we're talking about which part, which molecule you are talking about?
Sesamic food, sesamic seed.
Sesame seed, okay, I'll tell you. Sesame seed, the civilization-wise, it is one of the oldest oil seed which is known to us. Okay, we have been eating large amount of sesame seed as a form of seed. We are also eating large amount of sesame oil as a part. Okay. And these molecules which we are talking about is an oil, water-soluble molecule, not water-soluble. Sesaminol is water-insoluble, otherwise called oil-soluble. Okay. And when we are eating these fried food, and we had no such effect, but the only problem is you feel a little bit of heat which is coming out. Nighttime, which is useful.
Okay.
And the daytime. Daytime, you may sweat quite a lot, but the nighttime, actually temperature also goes down and your body is warm enough and you are okay with it. But so far, nobody has done large quantity. I'm trying to study what would be the effect if you give the highest dose. What is the highest dose we are talking about? That toxicity is not done so far.
Okay.
Many of the food molecules, which is known to us, toxicity studies are not actually done.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Now I would like to thank, first of all, give the vote of thanks. First of all, I will thank Industrial University for arranging this nice webinar and giving the platform for the students as well as others who have participated to learn more regarding the bioactive molecules from the plants. And hear you, sir. As well as I would first like to thank Dr. J.S. Yadav, sir, our provost. I would like to thank Dean Madam, Bharti Madam, from School of Science, as well as Dean from School of Engineering, Dr. Amish, Professor Amish Vyas, sir, our project assistant, Abhinand Pandya, sir, as well as I will thank all the panelists who have joined over here, and give my immense thanks for the technical staff, because of which we are seeing you, sir, right now, all these webinars, and all the students who have learned so many things regarding the bioactive molecules, as well as the BSc and BMSc students and others who have joined. And sorry if I have forgot anyone's names. And thank again once again thank to each and everyone. It was very nice talk, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you again for accepting the invitation, and I hope to meet you sometime personally in the university. Yadav sir will call, so we can have a personal physical interaction.
Definitely.
Yeah, it comes to come. No, don't worry. Actually, I was planning to bring him soon, but again, lockdown. Let it get. Have you taken the vaccine or no?
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful colleagues. I had a very nice interaction after such a long time. It has been a year. I had given a seminar to tell you because he's just not going anywhere, not accepting anything also, because I am not familiar with these online as well, but only now I have learned.
Right. So now we have started first webinar from you, looks like. Sorry, you have started first webinar from us.
Classes, my colleagues will help me to organize.
Right.
Here I am all by myself at this time.
Good. Anything else? Vijay, you want to say a few words? Kahan gaya Vijay, kidhar gaya?
Vijay, Bharti ma'am.
Vijay Singh, our bioscience head. And he did PhD from that agriculture in Lucknow only. Vijay Singh?
Vijay Singh is from Lucknow. Oh, good.
छोड़ दी गया क्या विजय सिंह
सर आई थिंक देयर इज कनेक्टिविटी प्रॉब्लम
कनेक्टिविटी
यस सर
ओके
सर आई ऑलरेडी फॉर्मली इंट्रोड्यूस्ड मींस एवरीबॉडी टू सर लाइक सर एवरीबॉडी इज हैविंग वेरी गुड पीएचडी एंड पोस्ट डॉक एक्सपीरियंस सो विजय सर वाज लाइक ही डिड पोस्ट डॉक फ्रॉम 3-4 डिफरेंट प्लेसेस And sir, I also did some postdocs and then I joined here. Yes,
sir. Sure. Actually, faculty is very good. Only is hardly 2 years old university.
Good. Young is dynamic, no?
Right. Okay, Ram, if there is no question, then we say goodbye to you. I don't like to leave you. Your smiling face is very good, always. Okay, then.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay. So we will leave now. Thank you, sir,
sure.
For accepting the invitation.
Thanks.
Bye.